The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 3, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 29th, 1975, in Nairobi, Kenya.
Translation: out of many thousands among men, one may endeavor for perfection. And of those who have achieved perfection, hardly one knows me in truth.
Manasyanam sahasyeshu kaschi jatati siddhaye jatatam api siddhyanam kaschi man vetti tat. So, to understand Krishna is not very easy thing. Krishna says, the manusanam sahasrishu. Out of many millions of persons, one tries to become perfect. Who is going to become perfect, especially in this age? Everyone is working like cats and dogs. Just whole day working for eating, sleeping, sex and defense. They are not manushyas. Ahara nidra bhayamaithanancha samanna metat pasubhi nara. No. Eating, I eat, dog eat. So what is the difference between eating, between the dog and me? He is eating according to his taste, I am eating also. The eating business is there, in the dog also. Don't think that because you are eating on table, chair, plates, nice preparation, it is eating. The people are taking that because I am eating on table, chair, and nice dish and nice preparation, therefore I am civilized. The Shastra says that it may be a different types of taking the eatables, but it is eating. There is eating the dog. It does not make any difference. You are not civilized. Similarly, sleeping. The dog can sleep on the street without caring for anything. We cannot sleep without nice apartment. So, eating, sleeping, making simply sex intercourse. So, dog has no shame. It can enjoy sex on the street, but we have got some restriction. But the sex is there. Similarly, defense also. Bhoy. Bhoy means to take care of fearfulness. That is there in the dog and in you also. It does not make any difference because you have got discovered atomic bomb for defense. It does not mean that you are better than a dog. This is Shastra Kingdom. Because he has to defend himself according to his intelligence. And you are defending yourself according to your intelligence. So this business, four business, eating, sleeping, mating and defending, these are common. Ahara nidra bhayamaitam samanamaitam. This is common. What is the special advantage of human life? The special advantage is athāta brahma jigyāsa, jīvasya tattva jigyāsa. He should be inquisitive to know the value of life, the absolute truth. That is, the dog cannot do it. That is the distinction between dog and human. The human being, in the human form of life, there should be inquiry about Brahma, Parabrahma. That is human life. So, after inquiring what is Brahma, Parabrahma, Janma, Dasya, Jataha, the original source of everything, when you attain Brahma Jnana, Brahma Bhuta. That is your purpose. Not that to compete with the dogs in eating, sleeping, mating and depending. That is not serious. That is not perfection of life. Nate vidu sartha gatin hi Vishnu. These foolish men, animalistic, dogs and cats, two-legged animals, they do not know what is the aim of life. Nate vidu sartha gatin hi Vishnu. Aim of life to understand Vishnu, the Supreme Lord. Durasaya je bahirathaman. They are trying to become happy in the bahiratha, in the external energy of God, material energy. And the so-called leaders, politicians, philosophers, scientists, they are all blind. They do not know what is the aim of life. Still, they are leading the whole society. Nate vidu sartha gatin hi Vishnu durasayaji bahirathamanina andhajathan dairupaniyamana stepi satantra urudamnibaddha. Urudamnibaddha. Uru means very strong and damni means rope. Just like if I tie with very strong rope, it is very difficult to open it and you are put into difficulty. Similarly, we are in this material world, urudamni baddha, tied, very tight with the laws of material nature. And we are declaring still, I am free, I am independent, I can do whatever I like. This is called imperfection. So long we are in the bodily concept of life, and think ourselves that we are free to do anything, whatever is life, we are in ignorance, darkness, tamo. Tamo means darkness. The Vedic injunction is tamasima, jyotirgam. Don't remain in darkness. This is darkness. Darkness means I am this body, and to fulfill the necessities of the body is the highest perfection of my life. Everyone is trying for that competition. Everyone is trying to have a skyscraper building and 3 Rolls-Royce cars and so on and so on. They think that this is perfection. Durasaya. Durasaya je bahirathamani. This material energy is production. But you do not think that how many years I shall enjoy this skyscraper building. And what is my main business? My main business is how to become perfect. There are many animals within this skyscraper building. There are human beings, there are dogs. There are cats, there are worms, rats, so many things. So, to live in this skyscraper building, that facility is there even to the worms, cats, rats, everyone. Then what is the difference between these animals and me? The difference is how to become perfect. Siddhi, Sarup Siddhi. What I am? Am I this body? This should be the question. Atharva Brahma Jigyas. Krishna says here that ultimate goal is to understand me. Vetimam tattva. To understand Krishna in fact, in truth, not superficially. That is required. Vedaishta sarvai aham eva vedam. If you are a great scholar studying all kinds of literature, Vedas, then you must know Krishna. If you do not understand Krishna, simply you study Vedas, it is useless, waste of time. You are executing your occupational duties very nicely, honestly. That is your life. But after executing your duties very honestly and nicely, if you do not awaken your dormant Krishna consciousness, then samaye vahi kevalam, you're simply wasting your time. Useless. When you understand Krishna, then it is the highest perfection. Saṃsiddhiṃ paramāṅgatā. So nobody is interested. Therefore, Krishna said, manusānāṁ sahasrīṣu. After many millions of persons, one may be interested. Otherwise, all are in darkness. So what is that siddhi? Siddhi is to understand one's constitutional position. What I am? I am trying to lord it over the material nature in so many ways. Is that my position? But I am failure. I am trying to lord it over the material nature as big man, as the minister or as the zamindar, as the big business magnate. And when I am failure, then I want to become God. That is another ambition. That is another ambition. So, this is not self-realization. The self-realization is that I am trying to lord it over the material nature in so many ways, but it is becoming baffled. Why? Why it is becoming baffled? With great endeavor, by political movements, I become the head of the political institution of the state, but I do not wish to die. Death comes, and it takes everything, my political position, my wealth, my everything, family, and anything. Mrityu sarva harascha hum. Who is taking that? That is Krishna. So when we realize that I am trying to accumulate so many things, but Krishna is taking it. Then why don't you surrender to Krishna? So that he may not take away your position. That is siddhi. That is siddhi, that I am not independent. I am trying independently, but it is not possible. I am dependent. I am eternal servant of Krishna. That is self-realization. That has been taught by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Jive sarupai nitra Krishna das. The Brahma realization, aham brahmasmi, that is liberation from material conception of life. That I am not this matter. I am not this body. But I am spirit soul, aham brahmasmi. That is the first step of realization, self-realization. But that is not final. The final realization is that I am eternal servant of Krishna. That is final. So long you do not come to this position, the final constitutional position, that we are eternal servant of Krishna, knowledge is lacking. There is no perfection of knowledge. Therefore, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Bahunam Janmanam Anti. After many, many births, Jnanavan, when one actually self-realized, in awareness, fully in knowledge, then he understands Vasudeva Sarvamiti. Vasudeva is the supreme, everything. I am simply part and parcel of Vasudeva, eternal servant of Vasudeva. Vasudeva Sarvamiti, Samahatma Sudullava. That kind of perfect person, Mahatma, is very, very rare. To understand that I am eternal servant of Krishna, my only business is to serve Krishna. That is my concept. I'm part and parcel of Krishna. This finger is part and parcel of my body. Its business is to serve the whole body. I ask the finger, come here immediately. This is the normal, healthy condition of the part and parcel. That's like leg. It is my part and parcel of the body. As soon as I ask leg, please take me there. That is normal. And if the leg cannot take me there, I have to take some stick. That means this is not a normal. It is disease condition. It has to be treated. Similarly, as soon as we find that we do not abide by the orders of Krishna, we must know that you are in ignorance and in abnormal condition. Madness. That is my duty. Krishna does not require my help. And still he says, Sarvadhamman Paritajya Mami Karmasaranam. That is my good. If I surrender to Krishna, then that is my benefit. Krishna does not require my service. He is omnipotent. But we are so rascal, we think, why shall I surrender to Krishna? This is imperfect. So when you come to this point, that you abide by the order of Krishna and surrender to Him, that is perfection. But they do not do that. Namana Diskitanam Murha Prapadante Naradhama Maya Puritagyana Suri Bhavan. Why they do not surrender? Not because Duskritina. All is acting sinful activities, Duskritina. And Mura, rascal, he does not know his own interest. Nati vidu sattagati Vishnu. Mura, rascal. And then Naradhama. Naradhama means lowest of the mankind. This human body was given to him by material nature to understand me, to surrender to me, but he will not do this. Therefore, lowest of the mankind. Now he is so educated that this is nonsense. If he does not understand Krishna, what is the meaning of education? There is no education. Maya puritagyana. Why these things are asuri-bhavama? Defying Krishna. Defying God. What is God? I am God. This is the position. This is the position, always, of everyone who is in this material world, and especially in these days, Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga, they are all first-class fools. That is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Mandasa mandra matayo mandra bhagya upadhita. Prayana alpaya ayusha kalau vasmin yuge. The Kali Yuga is very difficult yuga. Ignorance, the fight, war. Only fight, war. Kali means fight. Therefore it is called Kali Yuga. So in this age, especially, the inhabitants, they are manda. Manda means all bad. Nobody is good. And sumandha mata, everyone has got his conception of perfection. All bogus. Sumandha mata. Why this is? Manda bhagya. Because they are unfortunate. Everyone does not know what he shall eat next morning or in the evening. Everyone is in need. The scarcity all over the world. Mandasa mandamatayo mandabhagya, and still they are disturbed, so many. Especially with the increase of Kali Yuga, people will be disturbed by two things especially. What is that? Scarcity of food and taxation. That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Dudbikha karopinza. Karo means taxes. The people will be embarrassed for want of food at the same time every year increase of taxes. That is stated in the Bible. Dudbikha karopinza. Say, those so much disturbed that they will give up their heart and home and go away in the forest. Dudbikha karopinza. Achinna dardarvina gacchanti girikananam. Dardarvina. Money, wife, children, everything they will be disgusted. Now it is impossible to maintain. Let me go ahead. Gacchanti girikananam. So, this is the Kali Yuga position. So 5,000 years ago, Vaishnava Krishna spoke about Bhagavad Gita. At that time the position was Manushyanam Sahasresha. So, Sahasra, now on account of Kali Yuga, Manushyanam millionaire, because it has increased, the Kali Yuga has increased. Not sahasresu, and the percentage has increased, and millions. Therefore nobody is interested in this Krishna consciousness movement. There we are trying to give the highest perfection of life, but they are not interested. They want to remain like cats and dogs and suffer the consequence. Prakriti kriyamanani, gunai karmani, sarvasa, ahankara vimulani. So, Krishna consciousness movement is very difficult to understand, but by the grace of Krishna, it has been made very easy. That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Kalau dosa nidhe rajan asti jeko mahan guna. It was explained by Sukadeva Goswami to Parikrit Maharaj. He described the faults of the Kali Yuga, but he encouraged by one verse. My dear king, there is one very nice opportunity in this Kali Yuga. Kalau dosa nidhe, dosa nidhi, it is the ocean of faults. But there is one very nice gain in this Kali Yuga. What is that? Kītolāveva Krishnasya muktasamma parambhuji. Simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, one can become free from all the troubles of this yoga, the yuga, Kali Yuga, and muktasamma, and he becomes liberated, and he goes back to home, back to God. So take it very seriously, and make your life perfect. Thank you very much.
How does a person become humble?
That he has to learn how to become humble. Tinadaki sunite na tarurupishayo. If you preach Krishna consciousness, so many people will chastise you. The government will not allow you to go on the public street, and you will not got the visa, you will be refused to enter. So you have to tolerate all these things. That is humbleness.
And in fact, like here, it's very hard for them to understand Krishna consciousness. So my question is, what can we do?
Go and chant Hare Krishna and give them food, they are hungry, then it will be successful. Chant Hare Krishna, let them come and dance with you and give them prasadam, they are hungry. It will be successful. It's not difficult at all. That was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu preaching to the mass of people. You chant for 4 hours, and after finishing kirtan, you give them sumptuous food to eat. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has been Chaitanya, is it? You collect money not for your eating, but for distribution of prasad. That is it. And if you do that, Krishna will send you. Yoga khemang bahami aham. There will be no need. We have got about 102 centers. And in each center, there are so many people, up to 250. And not less than 50. So, Krishna is sending their food. There is no scarcity. We do not do any business. We do not go to serve any office. But Krishna is sending. 102 centers, average 100 men, how many? 100 into 100? So 10,000 men we are feeding daily. Apart from distribution of prasadam to others. So Krishna is sending. So you can attain. Everything belongs to Krishna. He will give you supply. You have to attempt only. So chant Hare Krishna and distribute prasadam. Your movement will be successful.
That we should chant 24 hours, Hare Krishna. If not, as far as possible.
Okay, you said that by chanting Hare Krishna only you can go back from back to Hare. So, if you chant Hare Krishna only, you're not following the questions, not really the words, can you go back to Hare?
Begin chanting, then everything will all right. Begin chanting, then all other things will be adjusted. Jena tena prakarena mana krishna nivesha sarvi vidhi nishedha su ekayo riva kankar. There are vidhi nishedha regulative principle. If you see that you are unable to follow, then chant Hare Krishna sincerely, then you will be able to follow the rule. Automatically.
You see about with the patriarch form and some signs of life every time you think about Krishna.
That will save you. If you simply think of Krishna and talk of Krishna, that I think we discussed this verse in the morning. If your mind is always absorbed about Krishna, then you are going to be perfect. Somehow or other, you think of Krishna. Manvana bhava madhvapta madhya nimam namaskar. This is the chance you are giving. Everyone can think of Krishna. Here is Krishna's form. Everyone can chant Hare Krishna. Everyone can offer obeisances. Everyone can offer some fruits and flowers. This is the opportunity. Manmana bhava mad bhakta madhya adhimana namaste. This core principle. Then gradually develop.
How may we best approach the rulers and the leaders and the politicians to interest the leaders?
You simply go and chant Hare Krishna. That's all. You flatter them. That other day I told, this, our preaching process is this. Dante nidhaya tunakam padaru nipatya. According to Vedic civilization, if one approaches before you with a straw in his mouth, that means he is fully surrendered. That is the sign. Therefore, Prabhupada Saraswati, he is speaking that with a straw in my mouth, dante nidhaya tunakam, dante, tip. Padayo nipatya. I am just falling down at your lotus feet and I have come before you with this straw, very humbly. Dante nidhaya tunakam padayo nipatya. Kakusatam krityat. And I am flattering you 100 times. Then naturally any rogue, any husband will be pleased. All right, you can speak something. It will become so humble and mean. There is no man in the world who will say, no, no, I am not going to hear. Of course, there are many askers, they will say so. But I have no time. So, anyway, generally people will hear. So, when he says, all right, what do you want to say? Dante nidhaya tinakam padhuru nipatta takusatam krityata aungabhata. He is sadhava. They say again flattering. Oh, the great sadhu. Although you know he is a great rascal. Still, I love to speak to him. This is the process of preaching. Is it all right? You tell him, oh, you are a great sadhu. Then he will hear, yes, yes. You are right. What do you want from me? Tell me. Then you can say, he is sadhava, sakalam eva vihaya dura. Whatever askeldam you have learned, please forget. Please forget. Then what I have to do? Chaitanya Chanda Charane Kruta Anurala. We become adhered to the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya. There is no. So I have brought this Chaitanya Charitamrita, 17 volumes. If you kindly take this, so there is no. They have got money. And if he reads one line, he will be perfect. This is your process of this.
Sir, Srila Prabhupada, I have your feeling. You say that by I must be humble or glory in his name. So, after that, what kind of word would you do that?
According to your karma. That I have repeatedly said, did you not hear?
He's asking about the animal. What kind of body will they take in their next birth?
They have got evolution by nature's force. They have got evolution by nature's force. Jalayana Valakhani, Savara Dakkavinsati, Kinwaya Rudra Sankata. First of all, aquatic, because the whole world was full of water. So there was animals, aquatic. So as the land becomes visible, then Jalayana Valakhani, Savara Dakkavinsati. Savara means the living entities which cannot move, that means trees and plants, vegetables. So, from aquatics to vegetable life, then worms, reptiles, then birds, then bees, then human beings, then civilized man. There is chance of becoming perfect. So, nature brings you up to the point of human form of life. Now you make your choice. Athāta brahma jīva. And if you misuse, play cats and dogs and again go to the aquatics or cats and dogs according to your karma. That they do not know. Therefore they are called mūrhas. They are very much advanced in knowledge and science and money making
But what they are going to take the body next life, they do not know. Mura, Nadirana. This is the advancement. Therefore they refuse to believe that there is next life. That is one solace. Other is not. Vasubhutasya dehasya kuta punaragamana bhava. This body will be burnt into ashes and he is coming back again. They don't believe. If they believe the Shastra, then it will be horrible effect. Therefore they do not believe. But if you believe and not believe, things are going to happen. That's all. That is laws of nature. If you don't believe that you are going to die, it doesn't matter, you have to die. If you don't believe that I am not going to become an old man, no, you believe or not believe, you must become old man. This is nature's law. So you believe or not believe in the next life, you have to accept it. Krishna says, Tatha dehantara prapti, virasatyamamuyo. So your belief or not belief doesn't matter. Nature's work will go on.
Regarding karma, one does his job every day. And if he spends some time in the evening in chanting Lord Krishna, he will lose it.
Oh yes, why not? Kalpamapi yasya dharma satrayate mahatova. If you think of Krishna once, that is not going then, that is recorded. Kalpamapi yasya dharma satrayate mahatova. Just as Ajami, at the last stage of his life, he chanted Narayan to become liberated. So something is about Krishna, is very good. And you get chance to increase. If you believe by chanting Hare Krishna, you will be liberated, then why 15 minutes, why not 15 hours? What is the loss here? If you chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, what is the loss? Is there any loss? For 15 minutes, chant, Kirtaniya Sadahari, as long as you can. Now, chant Hare Krishna.